say, can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hail at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming, and the rockets' red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say, does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave?
Hello and welcome. My name is Dr. Terrence Mims, Principal of Edmonds Woodbury High School, and I would like to welcome you to our Class of 2020 commencement exercises. At this time, I would like to respectfully acknowledge that Edmonds Woodbury High School sits on the traditional lands of the Duwamish, Skokomish, Snohomish, Snoqualmie, Suquamish, and other Coastal Salish tribes. Class of 2020, it's an honor to be greeting you here as Principal of Edmonds Woodbury High School. Graduation is a very exciting time as it represents a milestone event in every student's life journey. This graduation ceremony is obviously not a normal graduation ceremony. As we all know, COVID-19 has disrupted so much of our lives. But even though the pandemic has forced us to proceed with a graduation ceremony that is far from normal, the pandemic cannot diminish your accomplishment. You have all put in the work to be here today. You have earned the right to be celebrated as a graduate of Edmonds Woodbury High School. This is an accomplishment that you should be proud of. But this accomplishment is not yours alone. Class of 2020, none of you made it this far on your own. So before I go any further, I would like to give a big shout out to all the families of our graduates. I know that you've been instrumental in getting your graduate to this point. So a big thank you to all the families of our graduates. I would also like to recognize at this time the outstanding staff of Edmonds Woodbury High School. The Edmonds Woodbury High School staff works tremendously hard to make sure AW students have the very best of everything. So a big thank you to them as well. Class of 2020, you've reached an important milestone in your life journey. Each of you have worked hard to get here, and you should be very proud of yourselves. And as you all move into the next chapter of your lives, I hope that each of you continues to work hard to achieve your goals. Class of 2020, you probably know that we are living in unprecedented times in this country. COVID-19 has taken the lives of over 100,000 Americans, and millions of Americans are demanding an end to police brutality against Black and Brown people across our country. As this country moves forward, as real change is demanded by so many, I hope to see you, the class of 2020, leading the way. Lead the change we all want to see in our communities, class of 2020. You can do it. I know that you can. You're a truly amazing group of students, and at this time, I would like to share some numbers with you all that will serve as evidence of just how amazing the class of 2020 is. The graduating class of 2020 has 105 full IB diploma students, 136 students receiving gold cords. These are students with GPAs of 3.6 to 4.0. 51 students receiving silver cords. These are students with GPAs between 3.3 and 3.59. We also have 108 National Honor Society members. And finally, we have 35 students earning the Seal of Biliteracy. This means they've demonstrated competency in speaking and writing in a language other than English. You're an exceptional class, and I'm proud to have been your principal. I would like to close on a personal note. As you probably know by now, this is my fifth and final year as principal of Edmonds Wilbur High School. These past 5 years have been some of the best years of my professional career. I'm truly honored to have been able to serve as principal of such a wonderful school community, and I would like to thank you all, students, staff, and families, for your support and friendship during my tenure at EW. EW will always be in my heart, and I will miss you all. Congratulations, class of 2020, and best wishes to you all in the future. And now, here's our superintendent, Dr. Chris McDuffie.
After you've gone and left me crying, after you've gone, there's no denying you'll feel blue, you'll feel sad, you'll miss the bestest friend that you have ever had. There'll come a time, don't forget it. There'll come a time when you'll regret it. Someday when you feel lonely, your heart will break like mine and you'll miss me only. After you've gone, after you've gone, oh,
Julia Kim. Thank you. Hello, I'm Chris McDuffie, Superintendent. To the very special graduates of the class of 2020, a heartfelt congratulations. We are so very proud of you and your accomplishments, and we know that you are strong, you are resilient, and you will make an impressive mark on the world. On the wall in my office are the words of Albert Einstein. Learn from yesterday, live for today, hope for tomorrow. They have always meant a lot to me. Continue to learn, seek out new and exciting adventures. Try, fail, and try again. It's what makes us the best that we can be. Live fully in the moment. Always be present. Show courage, compassion, and kindness. And never lose hope for tomorrow. When times are tough and the clouds just seem to linger, remember, there will be brighter days ahead. From my heart to yours, take care of yourselves. Enjoy the journey. We are so very proud of you and wish you the very best.
Good evening and welcome, distinguished members of our school community. Superintendent McDuffie, Assistant Superintendent Schwab, Dr. Mims, Ms. Larson, Mr. Goodsguy, parents, guests, and our graduating class. When I stood up here in front of you a year ago during our ASB elections, I talked about a vision for our senior year. This was our year after all. I detailed all of those special moments coming in our near future, homecoming, prom, graduation. And I remember feeling nothing but excitement about our future together, the grand finale to be for the class of 2020. The first half was every part as amazing as we all had hoped. We started off showing up in the EW parking lot early in the morning with a delicious pancake breakfast, watching the sunrise as we envisioned the big year ahead of us. A short month later, we filled the gym with green and rallied like never before for a magnificent homecoming, finally taking home the coveted Spirit Shield. Time and time again, we packed the stands for thrilling fall and winter sports seasons. This was our class living our vision, enjoying the year we all knew we'd remember forever. Unfortunately, during this memorable time, my reality looked a little bit different. With little explanation, my life became ruled by a ceaseless pain that appeared out of nowhere. I was unable to play a match in the last tennis season I had long dreamt of. I struggled to stay on my feet cheering at sporting events. And getting through a school day became a physical challenge. Early on, I started processing how the senior year I had always imagined would be different. The mysterious headaches that plagued my daily life quickly reduced my routine to two activities: going to school and resting in a dark room. Both finishing the year and attending college became major question marks. I continued to smile and put on a brave face, but by the winter I had hit a wall. Luckily, a shocking February diagnosis and surgery shortly after restored my hope for the future, and I once again imagined living out our vision for the end of high school. Then, when everything seemed to be looking up, life threw another curveball at us. In the same unpredictable fashion that my headaches had emerged, we found ourselves in the middle of a global pandemic. Our glorious final days of high school were replaced by fear, solitude, and uncertainty. Rather than coming together as a class to celebrate the end of our journey with an extravagant prom, heartfelt goodbyes, and a tear-jerking march around the field, we were physically pushed apart and isolated. I know that this isn't the end of high school that any of us pictured or wanted, but it is now a distinct part of our experience. If this year has taught me one thing, it's that going through challenges in life makes us stronger people because of what we learn from it. After my surgery, I learned the value of gratitude, finding that every day I woke up without pain was a gift and not a given. And I believe that finishing our last year of high school from home has taught us all a truly brutal lesson about the value of time. It's so easy to think that there will always be another day, another moment, or another big thing to look forward to. So often we are guilty of sleepwalking through life and taking things for granted. Many of us thought of school as something we had to do, not a privilege that allowed us to enjoy time with friends, peers, and teachers. In the time since Inslee's announcement on March 12th, I've wondered what I would have done differently if only I had known that the year was ending 3 months too soon. I thought about how much I would give just to have one more day, at least to say goodbye to the people who had been in my life for so long. The truth is, we never know when the last time of anything is going to come. Just as suddenly as the life I had known slipped away in September, the end of senior year was ripped away from us. Since we have had to live through this, my hope for all of us in the future is that we make the conscious choice to live life day to day. When we live in the moment, we think less about what's on the horizon, and we focus more on who we are as people and how we treat others. Right now, that means appreciating unexpected amounts of time spent with family. It means making time to nurture and cherish your friendships, no matter how busy life gets. It means thanking people and letting them know that you care about them in the moment, so you don't miss that chance later on. Learning these lessons now will make us better citizens, friends, family members, and people in the future. The more I've thought about the loss of many of our senior year benchmarks, I've realized that it wasn't the events themselves that mattered to me. The real importance in celebrating our year revolved solely around being with the classmates, teachers, and advisors that had been a part of our lives for so long. And this realization filled me with hope. Because even though we didn't get the chance to throw our hats, to dance at prom, or to take down our targets and senior assassins, we will never lose the extraordinary friendships, memories, conversations, and laughs that we shared together. These bonds are what truly made our high school experience, and even a pandemic cannot take them away. It's no secret that today is not what we all envision, but I want all of us to hold our heads up high and realize that this is our legacy. Our class has demonstrated remarkable strength, resilience, and courage throughout these past few months that will distinguish us from anyone in history. In a strange way, there is a strong sense of togetherness in our isolation. Although we would much rather be side by side, standing under the stadium lights, know that we are all sitting around Edmonds and doing this together. Right now there are 400 of us, wearing purple and green for the last time as a class. So when the time comes, I want all of us to proudly turn our tassels and toss our hats into the sky. What matters is not where we currently stand, but the fact that we are and always will be Edmonds Woodway's class of 2020. Thank you.
Good afternoon and welcome, distinguished members of our school community, Superintendent McDuffie, Assistant Superintendent Schwab, Dr. Mims, Ms. Larson, Mr. Goodsky, parents and guests. Welcome to the large number of Edmonds Woodway faculty who are retiring with this class. You've made us younger teachers better with your guidance. We will miss you, the building will miss you. But really, we're here for the graduating class of 2020. Here are some thoughts for you, class. Look, we're all thinking, what a shame that your senior year came to such an abrupt end. Let's talk about disease, shall we? From the teacher's perspective, a huge thing has been that cases of senioritis are at an all-time low. This is a trend sweeping across the nation. In fact, this stunning reversal has gone so far that a new variant, an entirely new variant, called reverse senioritis, has showed up for the first time in our own building. That's right, some of you seniors have been caught pining for the fjords of high school. Now that has to be a good thing. Seriously though, it is time to change our mindset. Today we need to look beyond the lives lost, the careers disrupted, the new pressures put on every family in our community. In February, we all became the focus of national attention. Number one in the United States, both in COVID-19 cases and in mortality because of it. Through excellent leadership in government and foresight in the business community, through the sacrifices we all made and the diligence we've shown in social distancing, our state is now 22nd in the country in total cases. There were significant losses, both here in town and across the state, but we faced the unknown when it was truly unknown, stood together, listened to our leaders, and persevered. We did that together, and it's something all of you should be extremely proud of. It wasn't exciting, but it was extremely necessary, and thousands of lives were saved as a result. Here's the gift you've been given by accident. The shutdown's given you an early glimpse into adulthood, the way life will go after you leave our hallowed halls. What you'll be faced with after college is what all adults face. Without a roadmap, we manage our own affairs. Getting advice as we can, reevaluating new options we've never experienced, and creating plans that we hope will lead us to some form of success. There are innumerable paths in anyone's life, and most then we have very little to do with what you think you're taking now. So millions of choices and millions of voices. How can you tell who to listen to, who to follow as a guide? Here's one method that's always worked for me. When you meet new people, watch what they do when the bright lights are turned off. Everyone wants to look good on stage, in the spotlight. Remember and observe others when all is quiet, and you'll learn if you can trust them. How do they treat subordinates? The lowly, the forgotten. Then you'll know if you can hold them close or you should keep them at a distance. Also apply that insight to your own actions. Next, follow your love. Work is not work when you love it. All the little things, the drudgery that underlies every career, is made easier when you love what you do. You'll be much more successful in any endeavor when your heart is truly in it. The key evaluation should always be, am I happy with myself? Are my reasons for happiness legitimate? If so, then let that be enough. Stop driving and learn to enjoy this success. Follow your heart. Don't be so worried about your career at first. For the moment, ignore the noise about career. It's not always about career from the start. When I graduated from high school, in the days before light bulbs, life in your late teens was supposed to be an exploration. I think it still should be. You're simply not supposed to know everything yet, so look around. Use your time to take the road less traveled. Who knows? But it may well make all the difference for you as it has for me. One of my former students came to see me in December. She was on her way to New Zealand, alone. This was before the virus. She decided for herself that exploration would be a wonderful experience. She's seeking out, and you should do the same. She's seeking out adventure. She told me that the advice I gave her that she appreciated the most was this: don't be afraid to fail. I never trust anyone who hasn't failed and hasn't been pushed to the limit. There is no older person that you know that hasn't failed at something, or many things, many times. That's why we're wiser and more mentally strong than you are. But it's absolutely essential to learn from these failures. Repeating mistakes is the most terrible of wasted opportunities. Flipping this, don't forget to reflect on and learn from your success. How did I do that? What was it that made this time better and different from all the other times I failed? The last thing that I always do when I'm addressing graduates is something that needs to happen here. Sitting next to you, as you watch this in your living room, is a group of people who have been there for you for 18 years. When you came home from school upset in the third grade, they taught you how to think your way through the hurt, even though they felt but your pain kicked them right in the stomach. They may be your birth parents, or a close relative, or a friend who stepped in when they were needed. They're the very definition of a trusted adult. They may have moved far from their original home, just so you could go to school here. They picked this delightful place to raise you. They washed you and fed you and clothed you. They have driven you in pitch dark to every band practice, taking you to every swim meet, chess match, dance or gymnastics practice, soccer, football, or basketball game. When you brought home your first boyfriend or girlfriend, They may have winced privately and then made him or her feel welcome despite the pierced tongue and the lip tattoos. They always hope and work for your happiness. They've always been there for you. They'll always be there for you. They are here for you today and so very proud of you, even though you really haven't done anything yet. Today, as you enter the world of adulthood, I think it would be a good idea to show them some respect and appreciation. Your parent or parents have gone through life before you and have shown you the way through their experience for 18 years. Today, look them in the eye, give them a hug or grab them by the hand, and say, thank you so very much for everything you've done for me. I couldn't have done it without you. Thank you, class of 2020. I want to thank all of you from the bottom of my heart. For the past 4 years, you've supported me and made me feel like I was the richest person on the planet. Nearly every day, definitely every week, when I walk into that quiet building in September, when all of you are missing, a piece of my soul and the souls of my colleagues will be missing too. My hope for you all is that someday, somewhere in your journey, someone will give back to you what you have given me. Certainly continue to give it to each other and to all those you love. On behalf of the faculty and staff of Edmonds Woodway High School, I offer you our heartfelt congratulations. Class of 2020, welcome to the world.
Never understand. I've tried my hand, Good afternoon and welcome, distinguished members of our school community, Superintendent McDuffie, Assistant Superintendent Schwab, Dr. Mims, Ms. Larson, Mr. Goodsky, parents, guests, and of course, our graduating class of 2020. If you don't know me, my name is Bridget Smith. I think the reason I'm here delivering this strange virtual speech to you today is that I'm emotional, I'm reflective, I'm perhaps a tad too sentimental. I hoard memories, record them relentlessly, and keep hundreds of photos, and that includes every homecoming photo shoot we had on the library rooftop. I even have a journal entry from the first day of freshman year, September 7th, 2016. Dear Diary, had my first day of high school today. It was actually okay. I made a friend named Taylor in the first period. I also really like my bio teacher, Mr. Millett. I hope I never forget the feeling of walking into high school for the first time, how nervous and expectant I was. I'm not sure what's coming, but I have a feeling it's gonna be great. There are two key takeaways. Mr. Millett has always been a fan favorite, and I didn't know what was coming at all, not even close. I don't think my freshman self accurately expressed my terror in walking through the doors of Woodway for the first time. A school 16 times bigger than I'd ever seen, and seniors like giants telling us to walk faster. Along with that, I was never told to enjoy freshman year. I was told to survive freshman year to get to the good stuff, the cinematic, memorable, life-altering stuff. Senior year, prom, throwing our caps in unison today on graduation. Hundreds of Disney Channel originals conditioned us to believe that this was going to be our peak experience. And then we all watched in awe as every class before us did their hair, found the perfect outfit, and hugged the friends they'd made over the last 4 years with no masks or rubber gloves necessary. Class of 2020. We have a graduation that looks nothing like the graduation we were promised for 12 years, but I'm okay with it. What I want to celebrate isn't wearing a cap and gown and walking across the stage. I want to celebrate what truly shaped us as a class. I want to celebrate the confusion of freshman year as we came into our own, incredulous about the number of videos we had to make in English and Spanish, and stumbling around when someone pulled the fire alarm during our sixth period final. We learned how to survive in a chaotic, unfamiliar place and formed enduring relationships through that chaos. I want to celebrate the strength we solidified sophomore year, the year we faked understanding the ropes, faked knowing how to drive, and faked being able to handle the sudden ability to go off campus. We learned that words and actions mattered. We organized protests in a world we were just beginning to understand. I want to celebrate our determination as juniors, the year we strived to be the best at everything from students to snowman makers in the snowpocalypse. Yes, I am a certified class of 2020 historian. According to my recent extremely professional Instagram poll, the class of 2020, according to the class of 2020, is competitive, motivated, competitive. That one came up quite a few times, but we are also spontaneous, good-natured, diverse, resilient, and strong. And those characteristics are not determined by the last 3 months of high school. They developed over the days, weeks, months, and years long before today. A year cut short does not erase our achievements. The phrase I've heard the most these past few months from my fellow seniors is that we're missing out on the best part of high school. We were told it was all supposed to amass to this singular, cathartic moment, and it's been hard to watch that slip away from us. Grainy Zoom calls will never replace seeing all of your faces in person, but the more that I've been my emotional, reflective, and overly sentimental self, the more I've realized that high school does not come down to one singular moment. I now know more than ever that the best part of high school has already happened. Graduation and prom, those are ceremonies, but beating Meadowdale in a rainstorm on Stadium Jam, watching the multicultural fashion shows in awe, and slipping past Jordy for Panda Express at lunch, those are the unifying memories for the class of 2020 that could never be lost to a year cut short. I implore you all not to view this year as a disappointing ending or as a story of what could have been. Rather, this is only the beginning of the rest of our lives as resilient graduates shaped by the experiences, teachers, family, and friends over the last 4 years. With all of this uncertainty in the world, we have no idea what to expect next. But if this year, this week, has taught us anything, It's that no matter what challenges may arise, we can brave them. And gowns and tassels didn't teach us how to do that. We did. The season finale of a show isn't impactful because it's the finale. And the last page of a book isn't devastating because it's the last. It's poignant because of everything that came before it. All the insignificant moments we may have wanted to skip through, that's high school. Freshman year me was right when she said she didn't know what was coming. Because we never do. All we can count on is that it does come, in joyous, terrifying, and yes, always unpredictable fashion. I hope all of us can go into this next chapter, season, whatever you want to call it, not knowing what will happen next, because that's what keeps us watching anyway. Thank you, and congratulations again to the class of 2020.
Dr. Mims, Mr. McDuffie, Mr. Schwab, faculty, family, members, and guests. The class of 2020 represents the product of all the efforts of parents, family, faculty, and the students of Edmonds Woodway. We have prepared for this moment through many classes and activities that have developed our personal, creative, and academic potential. We are ready to take the next step into adulthood with the hope that we will be lifelong learners and responsible world citizens. Dr. Mims, it is my honor to present the class of 2020 for the presentation of diplomas.
Marla Nicole Thal. Maciel Gonzalez. Faith Quinn. Adidai Burhan. Ellie Grant. Avon Salah Yusuf. Michelle Alejandra Mendoza Cortez. Ava Helena Villavicencio. Rachel Vo. Natalia Wood. Ava Grace Wilson. Isabella Paige Wilhelm. Thank you. Sarah Louise Weber. Naomi Rebecca Weck. Yaya Wardak. Anthony Wing Wu. Isaac Andrew Wilkie. Sarah Madeline Wexler. Zoe Williams. Connor Nathan Vogt. Brandon Ung. Brandon Christopher Zabala. Madeline Joy Wicks. Caitlin Michelle Watkins. Yuting Ethan Wang. Jacob Lawrence Wilcox. Alvin Vukai. Jack Stephen Wattridge. Sydney Aaron Walsh. Grace Catherine Yaki. Ainsley Tia Lim. Cecilia Eleanor Robleski. Jada Brandy Votolato. Kristen Apigo Santorin. Jason Lee Shields. Tate Alden Stein. Kate Elizabeth Swires. Sarah Saleh. Christian Tyree Simpson. Cameron Stroud Stark. Moselle Ann Spurbeck. Elijah Patrick Thomas. Brianna Marie Turney. Vadim Torchillo. Elizabeth Priscilla Thurber. Benjamin Jonathan Skatanas. Anton Tepluhoff. Kendall Marie Summers. Kellyanna Ann Sperry. Abraham Trejo Sanchez. Ryan Alexi Simmons. Zachary James Treese. Julia Ninette Selk. Jory Robert Austin Gannon. Dustin Bernard Simarley. Elena McLaughlin Santa Maria. Dara Stotland. Alex Elizabeth Siki. Bridget Opal Smith. Hyomi Song. Allison Lorian York Stanley. Nicholas Andrew Sibiryakov. Ian Joseph Torres. Sydney Lynn Scott. Eileen Sierra Castillo. Winifred Weiling Tan. Eric Tai Pham. Ja Wong Phipps. Ronald Mwangi Payton. Gavin Edward McMillan. Giovanni Zakaria Shauki Solomon. Jordan Nicole Rubin. Emily Torres Sanger. Enma Selena Torres Pineda. Gabriel Michael Paquette. Antonio Joseph Ortiz Rice. Ramnik Kaur Rai. Amelia Ann Purcell. Mia Minna Oscarson. Alisa Chawan Park. Jared Dominic Perez. Emily Lee Fan. Harrison Lucas Gale Rothschiller. Caitlin Marie Pitts. Tabitha James Robbins. James Edward Randall. Angus Henry Raitt. Alyssa Brianne Reyes. Amelia Beth Reese. Gwyneth Lee Ralph. Malachi Arsene Kian Allen Redman. Maxwell Blake Pearson. Hannah Lee Rosenberg. Jacob Michael Reed. Liam Jaden Salas. Joshua James Rose. DeAndre Ray Rodenbaugh. Naminatu Sanko. Andrew Daniel Rutz. Isaac Shane Mergans Peak. Cesar Suarez. Jordan Matthew Pulley Howard. Rachel Danielle Putz. Jennifer Alejandra Leon Garcia. Josue Clemente Ramirez. Katrina Nicole Peterson. Amir Jabari Nero. Angela Nguyen. Juan Alberto Melchor. Clifton Dijon Montgomery. Thomas James Oliver. William Wallace Molinero Yallop. Alexander Hayford Moen. Maham Nadim. Sitlali Guadalupe Perez. Paige Victoria Olson. Daniel James Mickelson. Mickelson. Peterson Munn. Ellie Norton. Jose Rodrigo Moran Ramirez. Quinlan Elise Marin. Dominic Alexander Nye. Jenna Nicole Mills. Zafarula Raymond. Savannah Ari Nalamliang. Dawn Khan Nguyen. Ava Josephine Messinger. Caleb Allen Nichols. Christopher Uzochi Okolo. Tristan Gregory Moore. Sebastian Lee Olson. Francisco Monroy Sique. Criseida Maybelline Montano Flores. Victor Moreno Martinez. Raven Isa Newman. Hayden Quinn Mitchell. Isabella Manano. Isla Ann Middlestead. Diana Lee Oliveros. Mia Catherine Mattson. Sabrina Marie Majak. Samuel Jonathan Lukin. Matthew Lay. Joseph Lay. Isabel Una Madaf. Monica Isabel Landeros. Anthony Joseph Lenz. Stephen Mintry LeSmith. Gabrielle Destiny LaRoe. Madeline Rose McMahon. Maya Victoria Lysine. Gabriella Maria McCray. Arrington Von Victor Miller. Jonica Alexander Mays. Matthew Jonathan Lee. Vanya Liu. Grace Elizabeth Lewis. Emily Kang. Logan Gnome McDowell. Taylor Isabella Lang. Jacob Christopher Lester. Unati Naburi Macho. Nico Jordan Tamura McNeil. Alexis Joyce Martineau. Umama Khan Narejo. Gabriel Nicholas Curlin. Jacob Tadashi McGill. Zumana Ellis Kone. Alexis Omar Martinez Torres. Winston Hilton Lucas. Maxwell Eric Carr. Pilsung Kwok. Thank you. Jacqueline Leyva Criollo. Lisa Miyagi. Sierra Rose Lang.
John Edward Judd. William Jacob Judd. Nicholas David Inadomi. Fatou Jamet. Margaret Rachel Longstead. Nayeli Lucia Jimenez. Lissy Naomi Marin Contreras. Asmara Eob Kaflesius. Christabel Grace Jameson. Emma Natalie Karamova. Jin Kim. Yumin Kim. Camellia Siham Kadam. Jacob David Johansson. Amar Munaf Janu. Paige Kanibi. Isaac Nicholas Helgeson. Alexandra Kylia Huffman. Lydia Evelyn Hostetler. Miranda Lee Huff. Eliza Mariana Kishpa. Aaron D. Kim. Marie Ellen Kearns. Brooke Lynn Kearney. Elsie Caroline Johnson. Cassandra Itzamarie Guzman. Thank you. Edward Lee Kucherov. Stephanie Juliet Jansen. Julia Ellis Kim. Victoria Sandra Keys. Caleb Matthew Jansen. Hafsa Emin Iqbal. Amy Nguyen Huang. Kaveh Razi Hamadani. Jung-un Kim. Young Ho. Ariba Aswad Janu. Anna Kate Johnson. Emily Helene Hood. Tessa Leah Fleming. Ida Gay. Destiny Laurel Lee Harris. Kayla Naomi Gutierrez Andrade. Celeste Gould. Laurel Joan Gould. Veronica Flynn. Howard Alexander Hare. Sophie Gard. Marie Elise Gard. Anna Christina Fjortoft. Kai Fisher. Rylan Fisher. Carter Edward Holst. Amy Yuhong Fuji.
River Sky Freeberg. Michael Healy. Mia Bell Hare. Alexis Otoyo Haley. Nesta Yair Flores Gomez. Alexandro Benjamin Gámez. Ario Nathaniel Gassemi. Tony Gomez Mata. Kira Danielle Hicks. Elsa Liliana Hernandez. Talek John Crawford. Tayo Justin Hayes. Thomas Hawks. Samuel Ayabakari Balapre. Jadian Echan Estrellas. Lily Suzanne Frunk. Dallas Margaret Quartz. John William Douglas. Naol Tejuma Dabi. Patrick Alexander Peter Kolibabia Evulet. James Evan Berkland. Joseph Roque de Bella. Annalise Olivia Yunsen. Brian Cow. Amir Ali Abraham. Keelan L. Clearbrook. Andy Terecchia. Litzy Ebeth Canales Montiel. Muriel Leanne Fay. Caitlin Nicole Carroll. Kemmerly Jade Chapongian. Muriel Leanne Fay. Graham Nathaniel Roy Everhart. Malachi Pujari Espinola. Cameron Anthony Eaton. Jorge El Chavarin. Han Matthew Collison Carl. Quinn John Davis. Spencer Michael Budisbach. Nicole Jade Cootermarsh. John Michael Christian Erickson. Corey James Christian Erickson. Teresa Marie Del Rio. Jack Einer Doherty. Micah Lawrence Quintos Cortezo. Catherine Cesar Ramirez. Garrett Allen Coleman. Brendan Michael Ellermeyer. Kayla Deniputri. Josephine Olivia Cameron. Mia Ashley Dickinson. Belinda Marie Ehrenfeit. Joseph Andrew Aragai Kawilin. Elizabeth Kate Adams. Robley Dean Corsi. Woodling Carr. Taryn Sierra Gendron. Ethan Elijah Davis. Travis Kenneth Packard. Ariana Lisbeth Aravello Martinez. Stephanie Grace Farmer. Haley Grace Asher. Alexis Eve Bowie. Lauren Grace Bowie. Brian Bunya Tipanon. Julian Lawrence Bodar. Olivia Borkert. Priscilla Francis Arrico. Thomas Joseph Blayhouse. Sophia Elaine Alexiou. Myrna Elizabeth Alleman Cruz. Mm-hmm. Samuel Solomon Anulo. Danielle Ivy Arthur. Yasmin Sarah Almixusi. Brittany Brianne Brigham. Nicholas James Bellinger. Alora Boatwright Mars. Dylan Carbono Brower. Cameron Andrew Anderson.
Rachel Elizabeth Autry. Samantha Rose de Guzman and Daya. Mohammed Almahai. EJ Brannon. Diana Palamanova Angulova. Delina Abbey. Madison May Bacon. Alyssa Berman. Reba Mulagada Burhan. Gavin Noel Brockman. Jacob Wallace Burdett.
Kiona Emma Apio.
Justin Hyunjin Bae. Leland Jeremy Burdett. Cole Thomas Bosney. Natalie May Bergner. Aubrey Herlin Zay. Iman Imran Janu. Lainey Adams. Emmanuel Boakche Anza. Thank you.
Chinadu Justice Achilanu. Jaden Jennifer Warham. Osborne Thomas Nigley. Amrita K. Kumar. Lauren Marie Billing.
Zamir Zakoli. Angelina Vitalievna Galieva.
Where majestic mountains tower, near the shores of Puget Sound, stands our honored alma mater, with its memories all around. Ever strong will be our friendships, they'll live on though we depart. We will love you, Edmundswood Way, be forever in our hearts.
As your senior class president, it is my honor to lead you in changing your tassel. On the count of three, change your tassel from the right to the left. One, two, three. Congratulations, class of 2020. We did it.